In the same place where you lost it, in the same place where you have failed, in the same place where you have fallen, God will raise you up and He will make a difference with your life. Mistakes are not the end. Failures are not the end. Your failure is not final. Many times the devil tried to take you out with your mistakes or your failures. You might have fallen, but God wants you to know that you are not a mistake. You might have fallen, but God wants you to know that you are not fallen. You might be down, but He wants you to know that your destiny is not down. Your failure is not final. The devil is gonna try to make it look like the last time you failed is the last time you should try. Every time you wanna try something new, he's gonna remind you of the fear of what if. What if you fail? What if you can't do it? What if you can't achieve your purpose? What if you don't make any progress? What if you try everything and you still fail? What if nothing you do works? What if nothing you do makes any difference? Do it anyway. God cannot do anything for you if you are too afraid of trying. The truth is, you will fail. Failure is inevitable. What God wants you to know is that as surely as you will fail, He never sees a failure when He looks at you. He doesn't consider you a failure, so you shouldn't consider yourself a failure. If the devil can ever get you to look at or to see yourself in a way that God doesn't see you, then he can get you to believe less about yourself than who you really are. When he has succeeded in defeating you, then he has succeeded in defeating you even before you started. The last time you failed does not define you. You may have failed, but you were not a failure. The fact that you are down right now doesn't mean that that's where you would ever be. Failure is not permanent. Your story is still being written down. Don't write yourself off just yet. It doesn't matter how big a mistake you made. It doesn't matter how life-defining that failure seemed. Restoration belongs to God and He will surely restore you. If He restored even the Israelites whom He punished Himself, imagine how He's gonna restore you from the mistake that you have made yourself. The word of the Lord says, "Be glad then, ye children of Zion, and rejoice in the Lord your God, for He had given you the early rain moderately, and He will cause to come down for you the rain, the early rain and the later rain in the first month. And the floors shall be full of wheat, and the vats shall overflow with wine and oil. And I will restore to you the years that the locust had eaten, and the cankerworm, and the caterpillar, and the palmer worm, my great army which I sent among you. And ye shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God that had dealt wondrously with you, and my people will never be ashamed." That's Joel chapter 2 from verse 23 to 26. If you will succeed in life, then you must learn how to deal with failure. There is no success without failure. There is no winning without loss. There is no automatic winner. No one is born to completely win without failing at all. You must begin to look at future as a gift from God instead of letting the enemy to bring you to the mindset of thinking that failure means that there is something wrong with you. You must understand that failure simply means that you are normal. Failure means that you are on the right path. God is not moved by failure, so you shouldn't be. God is not ashamed of you when you fail. Neither does He write you off when you make a mistake. So why then do you do that to yourself? Why do you take failure to mean that there is something especially wrong with you? That you haven't figured out what everyone else has figured out? Failure is not final. You must say it to yourself until it begins to make sense to you, child of God. There is a very big difference between making a mistake and being a mistake. No matter how many mistakes Simon Peter made, Jesus never turned his back on him as his disciple. Whether you failed in your relationship with God or you failed in some other areas of your life, God wants you to know that He is still in your corner. He will always be in your corner. And if you keep pushing, if you keep fighting, if you don't allow this failure to determine the rest of your life, then He's gonna just work all things out powerfully for your good. Just learn the lesson and keep going. Don't let the failure keep you down. Don't let the fact that you are falling or The fact that you've made a mistake become the story of your life. No one could have been considered to have made more mistakes than Rahab. She was so well known as a prostitute that when strange men were being looked for in her city, the first place they came to search was at her house. It was common knowledge that she was a prostitute. She could have given up and decided to remain at that place. She could have let this mistake define the rest of her life by choosing to believe that all that she was good for was to be condemned as a prostitute. But she knew, and she understood that just because you failed doesn't mean that you are a failure. If at first you don't succeed, then just try again. If at first you don't succeed, it doesn't mean that there is anything wrong with you. She said to herself, I may not have experienced different, but I know it's possible. I may be down, but I will not remain down. I may have fallen, but I refuse to remain on the ground. God is waiting for you to decide enough is enough. Like Rahab, He is waiting for you to see the lessons that mistake or failure has been trying to teach you. He's waiting for you to get the fact that failure is not final. He's waiting for you to understand and see that He has been in your corner and He will always be. It doesn't matter what happens. You've got to arise and shine, for indeed your light has come. Your light, your glory is with you, and as long as He's with you, it's only a matter of time until you succeed. So fail as many times as you need, but don't give up. You've got to fail having the idea that no one who loves you and has got your back proclaims that you are a failure, and God loves you, and you should love yourself. So every single time you fail, you have to understand that you are only doing it because there's a lesson to learn from it. That you are only failing, and that doesn't amount to you as a failure. This failure is not your destination. It is simply, for lack of better words, a step on your way to your breakthrough. And like the Bible says in Micah chapter 7 verse 8, you also should proudly proclaim, rejoice not over me, O mine enemy, when I fall, for I shall rise. And when I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be a light unto me. The Lord bless you and give you strength to understand that your failure is not permanent.